Good morning, this is Dennis Woods, and I welcome you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ to the broadcast of the Sunday morning worship from St. Paul's Lutheran Church in California, Missouri. We are pleased to have you worship with us on this 14th Sunday after Pentecost, August 29, 2021. The congregation prepares itself for worship as the organist Twyla Duval opens the service with the prelude. This Sunday has been set aside as Youth Sunday. The procession with the cross carried by Landon Hayes has entered the nave of the church. The acolyte for today's worship is Jack Lake III, who has lighted the candle in the chancel of the church. Pastor Kopper has entered the nave of the church with the procession. The broadcast of this worship service is part of the gospel ministry of the members of St. Paul's Lutheran Church in California, Missouri. Today's broadcast is underwritten by memorials given in honor of those who have gone home to heaven. The flowers that grace our altar this morning are provided by Sonny and Twyla Duval for the many blessings God has bestowed upon them. The opening hymn for the worship service is I Can Only Imagine. Following the opening hymn, Pastor Kopper will lead the congregation in today's worship service found in the bulletin. The bulletin can be found on our church website at www.stpaulslutheran1860.com. Under the bulletin board menu.
I can only imagine what it will be like when I stand by your side. I can only imagine what my eyes to see when your face is before me. I can only imagine.
To my knees will I fall, will I sing hallelujah? Good morning. If we started a little different than we normally started, it's because today we try to put together kind of a different service for the youth. So you are part of that, of course, and the service is going to be a little different today with some different songs than we normally sing. But we're still praising our Lord and Savior Jesus, just in a different way. This is, as you see in the bulletin, this is the Youth Sunday, and we intend to do that every fifth Sunday of the month, when we have fifth Sundays, of course. So let us worship our Lord and Savior, and before that, I would like to welcome everyone, all those who are following us on Facebook, and also all of those who are visiting St. Paul's today. I invite you all to stand and start the worship service with me today. And we'll start today in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. We are God's people. Through His Word, He has given us wisdom and understanding to follow His ways. Yet there are times when we have chosen foolishness over wisdom, willful ignorance instead of understanding. Still, even now, our Heavenly Father invites us to come to Him and ask for forgiveness. Heavenly Father, the congregation, Almighty God, in His infinite wisdom and grace, He sent His Son, Jesus Christ, to die and rise for our sins. Because of Jesus, the joy of our salvation is restored, and no iniquity can remain in dominion over us. Therefore, as I call an ordained servant of Christ and by His authority, I forgive all your sins. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Give thanks to the Lord, for He is good. His steadfast love endures forever.
Give thanks to
the Lord of Lords. His steadfast love endures forever. To Him who by understanding made the heavens, His steadfast love endures forever. To Him who made the great lights, His steadfast love endures forever. The moon and stars to rule over the night, His steadfast love endures forever. Let us pray. O God, the source of all that is just and good, nourish in us every virtue and bring to completion every good intent, that we may grow in grace and bring forth the fruit of good works. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, O Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Congregation may be seated.
Good morning, everybody. I'm about as far away from the youth as you can get, but I do have an announcement this morning from the Board of Education. There are still some reserved spaces for anyone who would like to attend the Big Splash this evening at the Ellen Aquatic Center. Come and enjoy the picnic supper, pool time, or just enjoy the fellowship. Sign-up sheet is still on the table in the entryway. Do want to thank all the youth that are taking part in the service this morning. It's good to have you take part with us. Want to welcome all of our listeners on KRLL Radio, and I'll get out of the way.
So the Old Testament reading today is Deuteronomy chapter 4, verses 1 through 2 and 6 through 9. Now Israel, hear the decrees and laws that I'm about to teach you. Follow them so that you may live and may go and take possession of the land of the Lord, the God of your ancestors, is giving you. Do not add to what I command you, and do not subtract from them, but keep the commandments of the Lord, the Lord of your God that I give you. Observe them carefully, for this will show your wisdom and understanding to the nations, who will hear about all these decrees and say, surely this great nation is a wise and understanding people. What other nation is so great to have their God near them the way the Lord of our God is near us? Whenever we pray to him. And what other nation is so great as to have such righteousness, decree, and laws as the body of the laws I am setting before you today? Only be careful and watch yourselves closely so that you do not forget the things your eyes have seen or let them fade from your heart as long as you live. Teach them to your children and to their children after them. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Today's epistle is Ephesians chapter 6, verse 10 through 20. Finally, be strong in the Lord and in his mighty power. Put on the full armor of God so that you can take your stand against the devil's schemes. For our struggle is not against flesh and blood, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the powers of this dark world, and against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly realms. Therefore, put on the full armor of God so that when the day of evil comes, you may be able to stand your ground, and after you have done everything to stand. Stand firm then with the belt of truth buckled around your waist, with the breastplate of righteousness in place, and with your feet fitted with the readiness that comes from the gospel of peace. In addition to all this, take up the shield of faith with which you can extinguish all the flaming arrows of the evil one. Take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. And pray in the Spirit on all occasions with all kinds of prayers and requests. With this in mind, be alert and always keep on praying for all the Lord's people. Pray also for me that whenever I speak, words may be given me so that I will fiercely make known the mystery of the gospel, for which I am an ambassador in chains. Pray that I may declare and fiercely as I should. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
That was Jack Lake and Stephen Gentry with the Old Testament reading and the Epistle reading. And now we'll hear from Rebecca English, who will be singing Build My Life on You.
Promises. I
Thank you, Rebecca. Thank you, Stephen and Jack. We are kind of discovering talents in our congregation now. Huh? Let's listen to the gospel. If you can, please stand. The Holy Gospel is according to St. Mark, chapter 7, verses 14 to 23. Again, Jesus called the crowd at him and said, "Listen to me, everyone, and understand this. Nothing outside of a person can defile them by going into them. Rather, it is what comes out of a person that defiles them." After he had left the crowd and entered a house, his disciples asked him about this parable. "Are you so dull?" he asked. "Don't you see that nothing that enters a person from the outside can defile them? For it doesn't go into their heart, but into the stomach, and then out of this body." In saying this, Jesus declared all foods clean. He went on, "What comes out of a person is what defiles them. For it is from within, out of a person's heart, that evil thoughts come, sexual immorality, theft, murder, adultery, greed, malice, deceit, lewdness, envy, slander, arrogance, and folly. All this evil come from inside and defile a person." This is the gospel of the Lord. And when Peter and the apostles had been brought before the council, the high priest questioned them, saying, "We strictly charge you, do not teach in his name. Yet here you have filled Jerusalem with teaching, and you intend to bring this man's blood upon us." Let us therefore boldly confess with Peter and the apostles the one true Christian faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed. "I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, O Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended to heaven and sits at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From thence he'll come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen." Congregation, may be seated. Children, would you come up front? No children today? Oh, yeah. Good morning. How are you doing? Good? All right. Okay. I have a story to tell you today. And Jesus told this story. Okay, it's actually not a story, it's more like a lesson. Here comes Henry. I knew someone was not here, Henry. Hey, over here. There he goes. Okay, it was not kind of a parable or a story. It was more like a lesson. Do you know what a lesson means?
Yeah.
Yeah? What it is, Melina? That's okay. It's okay. A lesson, it's something that someone wants to pass on to you, to teach you, like how to make a cookie. Sometimes one of these days your mom is going to teach you how to make a cookie. So that's a kind of a lesson, okay? So Jesus taught a lesson today for people. He said something, and I'm going to try to teach you with the things I brought today, okay? And this is the first thing. Do you know why we have these things now? Let me spray a little bit on your hand, Jonah. No? It's a hand sanitizer. Do you know what it is? Okay, let me spray on my hand then. My hand first, okay? So it's a hand sanitizer. Do you know why we need that? You thought what? Ice cream? No, it's sunscreen. I know, I understood. Sunscreen, okay, yeah. No, it's not sunscreen, it's hand sanitizer. Okay? Jesus taught a lesson about cleaning. People were telling Jesus that if they want to be a good Christian, they have to keep all those rules and regulations, and they have to clean their hands all the time because they created those rules. And Jesus said, wait a minute. That's not the way we are good with God. That's not the way keeping rules and commandments and, well, not commandments, but the rules made by men. Jesus said we have to have a clean heart, okay? So now, if we want to keep our hands clean, we use hand sanitizer, right? Now, if we want to keep our dishes at home clean, what do we use? Soap. Yeah, so we put on a sponge and then we clean our dishes. Now, there is one more thing I want to show you over here. And I bet you like it. I hide it over here. One more thing. If you want to keep your teeth clean, toothpaste, right? You have to brush your teeth. Okay, this is the last thing. This is soap. Okay, so if you want to wash your hands, you better use soap. You don't have that kind of soap? That's okay. You can find it at Dollar Tree. Dollar General has. Okay, now, all of this, keep our house clean, keep our hands clean, keep our teeth clean. But Jesus said something about our hearts. Hey, pay attention to this, because this is very, very important. How are we going to keep our hearts clean? Can we use soap to clean our hearts?
No.
Can we use hand sanitizer?
No.
How am I going to? I can't. I cannot put hand sanitizer inside of my heart. Yes, Jonah. Who? Jesus. Oh, my goodness. That's a good answer, Jonah. Yes. We're going to keep, the only way to keep our hands, our heart clean, it is when we pray to Jesus and ask Jesus to forgive us. Okay, but let me ask you, how do we get our hearts dirty? How? What happened? Okay. When we say something wrong to mom and dad, when we do something wrong, when we do not obey, then our heart is kind of, yeah, it has a problem. So we have to clean up every day. So when we have our hearts kind of dirty, we go to God and we pray and we say, Jesus, please clean my heart so I can be a good person. A good kid, good children, good child, I mean. Okay, can we do that? Can we do that every day?
Yeah.
Yeah? All righty. Okay. Now I have a song we want to sing. A lot of different songs today, huh? Do you know that song, Change My Heart, O God? Do you know that? Okay. Ellie knows. And if you all know, of course, you can sing along. Let me see. It's very easy. Say, change my heart, oh God, make it ever true. You can sing along. Let's just start over. Don't be shy. Okay, again. Change my heart, oh God, make it ever true. Again. Change my heart, oh God, may I be like you. Did you learn it? Once more, everybody together, pay attention. Change my heart, oh God, make it ever true. Okay. Now, you all learned a lesson, right? To keep our hands clean, we use hand sanitizer, but to keep our hearts clean, we use prayer. And we talk with Jesus, okay? So let's talk with Jesus. Can you put your hands together? Well, put your hands together. Let's talk with Christ. Jesus. Dear Jesus. Thank you for this day, and thank you for keeping my heart clean. Thank you for keeping my heart clean through your sacrifice on the cross. Sacrifice on the cross. In your name we pray. Amen. All right. See you next time. You can go back to your seats.
In preparation for the sermon, the congregation joins in By Grace I'm Saved from the Lutheran Service Book 566. Pastor Kopper's sermon message for today will be titled Cleanliness That Is Godliness.
May the peace of the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ be with all of us today. From the Gospel of Mark, the 7th chapter, verses 14 to 23, especially the verse 5, we will meditate. Nothing outside of a person can defile them by going into them. Rather, it is what comes out of a person that defiles them. So after reading this Bible verse, dear congregation, I'm sorry to say, but the problem, it is your heart. It is hard to believe. The problem is always our hearts. Our Lord is saying that our problems come within us. Our problems are not external, but internal. The issue is not outside of yourself, but inside of you. This is the core. This is the main teachings of Jesus to the disciples on the 7th chapter of Mark. You have a problem in your heart, and you have to address. The Pharisees and the teachers of the law in today's gospel reading desire to appear clean before God. They, aside of the Ten Commandments that we have in one of the readings today, aside of many other rules and regulations, they had approximately 700 other rules that they fulfill, or try to fulfill, just to keep themselves right before God. So it was a daily struggle to externally show to everybody that they fulfill the laws. One of them, Jesus pointed, it was to wash the hands. And don't take it wrong, they didn't wash the hands because they want to keep themselves clean and against fighting against germs or whatever. No. They cleaned the hands, their hands all the time because they thought, well, maybe I touched a place where a Gentile, someone that does not believe in God or someone that is not perfect as I am, maybe touched that place, so I have to keep my hands clean. I am good. I fulfill the laws, the rules and regulations. I am in a good standing. This is what Jesus is talking about today. And this is the public to whom Jesus Christ is teaching a lesson. And then here is the bombshell from Jesus. These people, and he's quoting now Isaiah chapter 29. These people honor me with their lips, but their hearts, they are so far away from me. And I don't have to explain the Bible verse after what I just said about the scribes, the Pharisees, and most of the people in the Old Testament days. There is this need of showing themselves as the perfect person before God. But Jesus comes and points. The problem is not what comes inside of your mouth, because they also had so many rules about eating things. The thing is, and the problem is what comes out of your heart. In explaining further, Jesus told the parable, nothing outside of a man will make him unclean. Rather, what comes out of his man. So from within, out of men's hearts, Jesus said, then in Matthew chapter 7, or Mark chapter 7, verse 20, this is what Jesus said. It's the end of our reading of the gospel today. From out of man's hearts come evil thoughts, sexual immorality, theft, murder, adultery, greed, malice, deceit, envy, slander, arrogance, and folly. Wow, I get depressed just reading all those words. And this is the gospel of Jesus. And we read all these words, and Jesus is saying it comes from your heart. And then you ask yourself, but I am not redeemed by Christ. I don't come to church every Sunday. I am not baptized. I'm not a children of God, and how this can happen? Then we look inside of us and we see that this is only the truth. Our heart sometimes, or most of the time, are just like that. There was a research among Lutherans in 1970. It's a long time ago, but still kind of standing. And this poll, they asked, this research, they asked 5,000 people about evil and good. They asked, it is your heart good or bad? And 50% of the people, the Lutherans, respond that the heart is either bad and good. So we have to, every once in a while, go back to the book of Genesis and read the book of Genesis and study the book of Genesis and remind ourselves, as bad as it seems, that we, our hearts are bad. And it is from our hearts that comes all the things that messes up our relationship with God. The Apostle Paul says in Corinthians, Romans chapter 7, verse 15, and he says this for a reason. Listen. I do not understand what I do, for what I want to do, I do not do, but what I hate, I do. He is talking about his heart. He wants to do things right, but sometimes his heart just takes him to a different direction. Jesus' message today, it is to repent to unrepentant people. I'm sorry, unrepentant people. Check your hearts. It is a daily battle we have to find against those thoughts, those things that come out of our hearts. And Jesus said, those things defile a man. Those things make a person unworthy before God. We for a reason, we have those two readings, the reading of Ephesians, about putting this shield, the armor of God. And we also have the reading of the commandments. When we put all these three readings together, and people work hard to put readings together so they make sense for us every Sunday. Every Sunday is a different lesson. And we have to connect those dots. When we hear the Old Testament and we hear about the commandments are here to remind us all that, you know, there are rules and regulations we follow, yes, but as Christians, if we fail, we have then the grace of God. But the commandments is kind of a guideline for us, how to live, how to behave, how to try hard to be in a good standing before God. Because from our hearts come so many bad things, and we have to put a fight, a good fight, every day. And if we don't do it, then we become just like the Pharisees. We come to church every Sunday, and once you get out, my life is just the same as the life of anybody else. I show no love for my neighbor. I show no faith for my Lord and Savior. I just behave as anybody else would behave. And this is in a short version of Jesus' story, why we could and how we could apply to our lives today. It's from our heart that comes all the evil things, and we have to address. It is not somebody else's fault. It is my own fault that things happen in my life that I sin against God. It is this man that Jesus healed in a well. It's recorded in John chapter 5. Jesus healed this man, but the man didn't know it was Jesus who healed him. Days later, the man is in the temple talking with the Pharisees, and the Pharisees were asking him, you know, how Jesus did. And he tried to explain to them, but he didn't know Jesus. He didn't know was Jesus the Messiah who healed him. He just said, this man came and asked me to walk, and I did, and I'm walking again. And then Jesus comes to him again, and here's the conversation. Later, Jesus found him at the temple and said to him, see, you are well again. And then look what Jesus says, stop sinning, or something worse may happen to you. Stop sinning, or something worse is going to happen to you. Worse than your physical problem. Something worse will happen to you. You're going to go to hell. We take the grace of God and the commandments and everything for granted. We sometimes even forget we're Christians. And we blame everybody else but ourselves. And this is what Jesus is saying. Look inside of you. Check your hearts. Daily repent. Come to Christ. Yes, the question is, and it is always this question, Jesus said to the man, stop sinning. We all know we can't stop sinning because of our nature. What Jesus means is that we have to put a fight against those things that makes us sin. We have to repent, and we have to let Jesus take control of our lives. We do not conform with the things of this world. We fight against it. Then we receive the blessing of peace that only Jesus can give us. The devotion to God, this clean hearts, takes us to a godly life. It takes us to service. This is Jesus' lesson today. We clean up our hearts. We come before God humbly, repent, receive forgiveness, and then start serving. It's a process. The problem is in us. The solution, it's not in us. That was the second lesson of the gospel. The Pharisees thought because they did that, because they didn't do that, because they didn't eat certain foods, they deserve whatever they think heaven would be. They didn't have not all the Pharisees and Sadducees had the idea that heaven exists. Jesus is saying, the solution is not in you. Yes, the problem is, but not the solution, because we cannot achieve salvation and eternal life. We cannot on our own receive salvation, but God in His mercy and His love sent His Son to tell us, even though you have this heart full of sin, I died for you on the cross. I saved you, and I'm giving you opportunity to repent and come to God and receive salvation. This is our story with God. If our natural condition, if our sins, if our heart condemn us, and because of that we cannot present ourselves pure before the throne of God, God in Christ sent His Son so He can do that for us in our place. Yeah, so don't worry. Sometimes if from your heart comes things that you really don't want to show, or you cannot even control, because that's happening, especially when you're driving, right? In California, on Main Street. I have to control myself when I drive, because sometimes an old person is driving in front of me and driving 15 miles per hour, and I'm in a rush to come to church. That's my early morning lesson. Be patient. Don't say anything, especially when Melina is sitting in the back seat. She said, Daddy, Daddy, don't say that. Don't do that. See, the lesson comes from my daughter. But yes, comes from my heart. It is a lesson. It is something that I have to learn every single day. And I have to say to myself, Lord, forgive me. Because it is from my heart comes evil things sometimes. But even though it comes, God will forgive me when I come to Him in repentance. The good news it is that Jesus died for people with ugly hearts like you and like me. That through His sacrifice on the cross, He offers forgiveness and daily opportunities to call upon His name, to receive forgiveness and the life everlasting. So may the peace of our Lord and Savior Jesus be with all of us so we can continually come to Him in repentance and receive new opportunities, not only to be with clean hearts, but also to serve Him with all the gifts we have. In Jesus' name, amen.
The congregation will sing, I Am Jesus' Little Lamb, from the Lutheran Service Book, page 740. And then Pastor Kopper will lead us in prayers of the church.
Let us pray for the whole people of God in Christ Jesus and for all people according to their needs. Eternal Father, O God, our Creator and Redeemer, we thank You that You have drawn us to Yourself by the power of Your Word and our Savior Jesus Christ, O Lord. For Your promises of life and salvation, we give You praise and adoration as our God and Lord. Keeps us in a steady faith in You. Guide our steps in the ways of Your life-giving word and makes us to be evermore Your people of hope, love, and life. Lord, in Your mercy. Lord Jesus, as You strengthened Your early apostles by Your very presence, so give strength and courage to church workers who continue in Your service to this day. Guard and protect them from the assaults of the devil, and bless their service in Your word and sacraments. Lord, in Your mercy.
Hear our
prayer. O Heavenly Father, give healing and comfort to all who are in trouble, danger, or illness. We lift before You today Clarice and Jim Alexander, Stephanie Beck, Bill Bass, Kurt Blyke, Helen Borgert, Mary Lee Brizendine, Mary Ann Clinton, Emma Douglas, Larry Gish, Joe Green, Karen Hagemeyer, Wayne Hagemeyer, Glenda Hamilton, Iris Hack, Ruth Higgins, James Hurt, Carol and Don Youngmeyer, Joyce Kislin, Carl Kister, Stephanie Marshall, Brad O'Neill, Leslie Powell, Bill Rader, Michael Rex, Cesar Schirmer, Gary Snyder, and Edwina Schock. Sustain their courage and faith in you and your mighty care. Lord, in your mercy. Heavenly Father, we also pray for the family and friends of Lakota Strobel, who passed away yesterday. The family of Rick Percival and Latonya Percival. We pray, O Lord, that you'll be with the family and that you will give them the love and surround them with your grace and the sure hope of the life everlasting. Heavenly Father, we pray for all of those who are suffering with the floodings in our country. Give them the assurance that even during catastrophes, you are in control and looking upon them. Restore their lives, Heavenly Father, so they will know you are their God and their Lord. Oh, Heavenly Father, we lift up to you the people of Afghanistan and all those Americans who are still there. We pray that you would take hold of them and help them walk through this fearful time. Protect them under your wings and help them feel the comfort and peace that only comes from your powerful presence. Deliver them from the evil regimes that inflict so much pain and hardship upon their countries. Be merciful and help them, O Lord. O Heavenly Father, we ask your blessing upon our event this evening, the Big Splash. May the activity bring the people of St. Paul's together in fellowship and friendship, that we might honor and praise you for the gift of friends and family that share the same faith together. Heavenly Father, into your hands we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. If the congregation please stand so we can pray the Lord's Prayer together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace.
It has been our pleasure to have you worship with the members of St. Paul's Lutheran Church in California, Missouri, through the facilities of KRLL Radio. May God's holy angels watch over you and your loved ones. Your announcer has been Dennis Woods. To close out the worship service, the congregation has sung Pass It On, a favorite hymn of us, many of us.